Hello everybody, Dan here from In Survival, and first of all, let me start off by saying, I apologize for taking so long to put out another video, just a lot of personal stuff going on. I'm getting back into it. I'm able to get back into it. So, my deepest apologies to everybody out there. And hopefully, my first video back, you guys will enjoy it. So I'm gonna get right to it. What I'm gonna do, basically, see this bungee cord behind me? If you're out in the woods and you're stuck and you can't seem to find the materials you need to, not materials you need, but maybe like a sapling or something. For some reason you can't, you're in a situation where you can't get to one, maybe you're injured, or you have to stay around camp due to predators or in the area or something. What I want to show you is basically a way to make a snare, because as most everybody knows, there are always little critters and stuff around, and when you're sleeping at night, more than likely there's critters coming into your area. So basically what I'm going to show you is how to make a bungee cord snare. And all I'm going to do, I'm going to be cutting this up and taking the individual rubber band strands out from the inside, and I'm gonna get to it, get that taken care of, and then I'll get right back to you. All right, so for video demonstration purposes, right now, for snare wire, I'm gonna be using 550 cord. You guys remember the old Dollar General saw. So right now I'm gonna start cutting and carving the snare pieces. First thing's gonna be the posts. And so these are going to be my side posts. I'm going to get them carved and notched out, and then I'll get back with you. just not taking any chances that any of the string or anything will catch on that. Alright, now this is going to be my bait stick, and I've actually got a trick that I do with my bait sticks and my trigger sticks. Now this is obviously, well, not obviously, but this is going to be the back end that goes against the anchor stick. And what I do with my trigger sticks is I like to flatten them out on one end and then take the sharp edges off. The reason I do that is it kind of gives it, well, I mean, you don't want to take it right to a point. You want to be able to have that flat edge against your trigger stick. But that flat edge with a slight rounded top portion, I don't know if I'm even getting this on the video. You can see that I just barely took some off of that. So what I do is now I'll do close to the same thing on the trigger stick. And then once these two edges are together, it'll take very little. Once these two edges are together, it'll take very little to get it to trigger the trap. So I'm gonna go ahead and carve my trigger stick and I'll get back to you. All right, so right now I'm just setting these up, getting them in the ground, and then I'm gonna set the rest of the snare up, let you take a look at it. There you go. Now once I set the snare up, I'll turn you back on. Okay, so here's what we would have right there. You'd have a stick in the ground that could either be a walking stick or a tent post. If you don't happen to have a bungee cord, you can actually take apart one of the tent poles for your tent, if it's got shock cord in it, and you can use shock cord as well. Now, basically what I did here, it's just an old broom handle, but like you could use a twig if you got a twig laying around, or not a twig, but a stick laying around camp, or like I said, a tent post or a walking stick. Just make sure it's in the ground good enough where you can tie to it. Stretch it out. There you see the bait stick with the snare on it. This is just like a regular spring snare, only with bungee cord or shock cord. All right. Now I'm going to set the camera back up and show you that it works. Here comes your little rabbit or squirrel or field mouse. He gets in there, he gets on that bait stick. Now remember, the 550 cord is taking the place of snare wire. So that would be snare wire around your prey's neck. There you have it. See you next time.